Okay, let's continue from here, and we are going to go to the muscles on the back. So the muscles on the back are very important because they are obviously are going to give us the movements to all the back area of our body. And the muscles that we have in there are going to be the trapezius up here. Okay, and then we have the deltoid. And immediately below the trapezius, we're going to have the latissimus dorsi, this muscle, right, big muscle right here. And also, in this little window, you can see the infraspinatus, teres minor, teres major. You see these ones on this other view, they're a little bit better. We have, as I said, infraspinatus, teres minor, teres major. You need to remove that trapezius in order to see these muscles that you have in here. These ones are going to be the rhomboid minor and the rhomboid major, as well as the splenius capitis right here in your neck. In the back, obviously, we have the gluteus maximus. If we have a maximus, because we have a medius, and in addition to that, we also have a gluteus minimus. Okay, let's scroll down from here. We have deep muscles of the back. As I was telling you, you don't need to know the deep muscles. So we keep scrolling down. We are going to get to this area, which is going to be the pelvic floor and perineum. Right here, you see the pelvic floor in the case of males and the case of females. It's the same area, but obviously from the male and the female point of view. You have in here superficial transverse perineal muscle, which is very important. In the case of females, you have deep transverse perineal muscle right here. You have the external anal sphincter, as well as in males, right? And in the case of males, you have the pulvis pontosum as well as ischiocavernosum muscle. Obviously, in the very back of both cases, male and females, you're going to have the gluteus maximus. The inside view of it is this one right here. But as I was telling you, you don't need to know the muscles that you have in the body. We keep scrolling down. You're going to see that that's it for this part. Okay, the next part in this chapter is going to be muscles in the shoulder and upper limb. Let's scroll down. Okay, we get to this figure where we have in the anterior view, we have the biceps right here. On the inside part of the biceps, we have the coracobrachialis. On the outside part of the biceps, we're going to have the brachialis, and we have this big muscle, the brachioradialis, that goes basically from the arm to the forearm. That's in the anterior view. We also have pectoralis major as well as deltoid. If we go to the posterior view, it's this one right here where we have the triceps. We have seen these muscles already, supraspinatus, infraspinatus, teres minor, teres major, as well as the latissimus dorsi when we were looking at the back. Okay, but right here you can see that we have the triceps. Okay, let's scroll down. And right here you have a better view of the biceps, as well as where the coracobrachialis and the brachialis are located. Let's scroll down. And we're going to get to the forearm. But these ones are deep muscles, as I was telling you, you don't need to know those. Maybe the pronator teres, because you can see this also from the superficial view. Let's keep scrolling down. Let's see that. And right here you can see this is the forearm. Okay, but this is the anterior view where the palm is. Okay, so right here, this area, the bones that we have right here, they are going to be carpals. This bone is radius. This bone is ulna. And these muscles are going to flex. Therefore, this muscle right here is going to be flexor, carpi, ulnaris. This muscle right here is going to be flexor, carpi, radialis. And in between these two, you're going to have this long muscle that is going to go to your palm, and this one is going to be called palmaris longus. Again, this is the anterior view of the forearm. That's why in here you have the palm. Let's just scroll down, and we get right here to the posterior view of the forearm. So if the anterior muscles in your forearm were for flexion, then these ones are going to be for extension, right? So these ones are going to be extensors. So right here, same thing. These are going to be, the bones are going to be the carpals. This is your radius, and this is your ulna. So then these muscles right here are going to be extensor, carpi, radialis. This one right here is going to be extensor, carpi, ulnaris. This one right here in the middle, this is not the palm. This is the dorsal side of the hand. Therefore, this is going to be extensor digitorum. A couple of notes that I have to mention in here is that for extensor carpi radialis, we have two. One of them is extensor carpi radialis longus, and this one right here is going to be extensor carpi radialis brevis. In addition to the extensor digitorum, we also have one next to it, which is extensor digit minimi, this one right here. Okay? If we scroll down, we're going to get to the hand. And in the hand, we're going to see the hand, the part where we have the palm. So if you look at these, are going to be the bones, are going to be the metacarpals. This bone, these muscles right here are going to be lumbricals. This one's right here. These are the lumbricals. For the thumb, you're going to have two very important muscles. This one is going to be the opponent pollicis, and this one right here is going to be the abductor pollicis brevis. These are very important muscles because this one will allow us to grab things with our hands. A little bit lower, we're going to see the dorsal part of our hand, where we're going to see that in between the metacarpals, we're going to have the interosseous, as you can see right here. And if we scroll down, that's going to be it for this part. Okay, the next part in this chapter is muscles of the limb. And we're going to see right here that these muscles are the ones that we're going to have in our limbs, in our lower extremities. So at the top, we're going to have the iliopsoas. This is the iliacus, and this is the psoas major. We also have another one, obviously, that is going to be the psoas minor. These muscles right here are in the inner thigh or the groin. In this area, we're going to have adductors. So we're going to start with the pectineus. Then we have abductor magnus, which is this big one right here. Then we have abductor brevis and abductor longus. If we scroll down, we are going to see that right here we have the posterior side of the legs. So the opposite to the iliopsoas is going to be this one's the gluteus maximus. So right here, we talk about this, we have another one, which is the gracilis. We have in here in the posterior back of your leg, we are going to have the hamstring. The hamstring is composed of three muscles. We are going to have the biceps, semitendinosus, and semimembranosus, which is this one right here. Okay, so then the hamstring is composed of three muscles, as you can see here, biceps, semitendinosus, and semimembranosus. If we scroll down, we're going to get to the anterior part of the leg. And in here, we're going to have a group of muscles called the quadriceps, right here in the very front of the leg. The quadriceps is called quadriceps because it's composed of four muscles. And those are going to be the rectus femoris, vastus intermedius, vastus lateralis, and vastus medialis. You need to remove the rectus femoris in order to see the vastus intermedius, as you can see right here. In addition to that, we have two muscles. One of them starts up here and goes inside towards your knee, the inner part of the knee, I should say, and that's the sartorius. The other one starts more or less at the same area and is going to go down, but in this case, it's going to go to the external part of the knee, and that's going to be the tensor fascia latae. We have seen these muscles already. These are going to be adductors. As we said, we have Dr. Magnus, we have Dr. Brevis, longus, and also the gracilis is going to be right here. If we scroll down, we are going to get to the lower part of the leg, where we are going to see the anterior part, where we have this very long muscle right here, which is going to be the tibialis anterior. Next to the tibialis anterior, we're going to have the fibularis longus. These muscles right here are basically from the back. So that's why, since we don't have a lot of muscles in here in front, that's why we can see the muscles on the back, and that's what we're going to see in a little bit. These muscles are deep muscles, so we don't need to know those. So if we scroll down, we're going to see to the posterior part of the lower back, of the lower part of the leg, and we have in there the gastrocnemius, this very big muscle that we have on the back. Usually people refer this as the calf. If you remove the gastrocnemius, you're going to have this muscle right here, which is going to be underneath the gastrocnemius called soleus. If you scroll down, we're going to see the deep muscles in the posterior part of the lower leg. But again, you don't need to know those muscles because those are deep muscles. If we keep scrolling down, we're going to get to the feet. So before we get to the feet, I wanted to stop right here in the extensor digitorum brevis because this is the only muscle basically that we have on top of our foot. Okay, all the other muscles are going to be on the plantar side of our foot, as we can see right now that we're going to scroll down here. So we can see right here, as you can see right there, most of the muscles are on the plantar side. The only one that if you need to know, I guess, is the flexor digitorum brevis because it's this large muscle that we have right here. Abductor hallucis is another one, but that's basically for the big toe right here. But that's about it. I mean, there's not many muscles that we can talk about in the level of the foot. Okay, and with that, we scroll down, and that's about it for this part, basically.